Hello friends, today we discuss about infectious canine hepatitis. Infectious canine hepatitis is a disease of dogs that usually affect the young dogs. The causative agent is canine adenovirus type 1 and type 2, and this virus causes the disease which is commonly known as the infectious canine hepatitis. Younger dogs are more susceptible to the disease with a high mortality. So you be careful and get your pup vaccinated in time. The transmission is mainly by fecal-oral route, and direct contact mainly spreads through contact with urine, feces, saliva, or nasal discharge of the affected dog. So any dog coming in contact with the infected dog's urine, feces may get the disease. Contaminated objects, viruses can survive on surfaces, contributing to fomite transmission. So be careful. And inhalation, airborne transmission can occur when infected dogs are nearby. So be careful so that your dog is not affected. Then the clinical signs of the disease, we discuss about them. Fever, there is sudden onset of high fever, and there is a saddle curve type fever, which is a common early sign of the disease. Then gastrointestinal signs, vomition, diarrhea, and abdominal pain, and the abdomen appears tucked up. So be careful if your dog is showing the following signs. Then hepatic signs like swollen and painful liver, jaundice, yellowing of mucous membranes, and abdominal distension, sometimes edema at the neck can occur. Then a dog may show hemorrhages in the buccal cavity, which is very disturbing for the owner. Then ocular signs, inflammation and edema of the cornea, blue eye, commonly known as blue eye, may occur once fever has subsided. So be careful. Then in rarely, blindness may follow in some dogs affected with infectious canine hepatitis. A dog may show respiratory signs, coughing and nasal discharge, and the diagnosis, the first diagnostic approach is the based on the observed clinical signs or symptoms, and then we can go for blood tests, detection of elevated liver enzymes and other abnormalities can help in the diagnosis of the disease. Then PCR testing, polymerase chain reaction test to detect viral DNA can confirm the disease, and detection of antibodies against CAV1 can help in the diagnosis of ICH. Then animal that is used for inoculation is the ferret, which is used to diagnose. Then treatment, since the disease is viral, so one should take care of, provide sufficient supportive care, address the symptoms and support the dog's overall health. Intravenous fluids, maintain hydration and correct electrolyte imbalances by administration of appropriate fluids. Serious cases such as those with liver failure, seizures or coma may require hospitalization with intensive care and appropriate administration of the medicine based on the clinical signs appearing. Antibiotics are used to prevent or treat secondary bacterial infections that may ensue, and administration of neomycin is suggested to kill ammonia producing gut E. coli lactulose to make the GIT environment acidic and promote the lactobacillus growth. Antiviral medications, while no specific antiviral drug for CAV1 exists, supportive care aims to help the dog's immune system and combat the virus. The administration of immunomodulators such as intravenous immunoglobulin in severe cases, IVIG may provide passive immunity and support the immune response. Administration of vitamin C and vitamin E can be attempted. Blood transfusions are required in severe cases with bleeding disorders. Then the administration of hemostat should be used carefully as they may delay the healing and sometimes cause tissue damage. The best approach is prevention of the disease. And for this, one has to recover dogs, shed virus in their urine for at least 6 months. So be careful with the recovered dogs. Routine vaccination with a combination vaccine that includes protection against CAV1 and other diseases starting at 6 weeks is very useful. Then hygiene practices, regular cleaning of living areas to prevent the spread of the virus are useful to spread the disease. Infected dogs should be isolated to prevent transmission to susceptible animals that may contract the disease from the affected dog. Avoiding contaminated areas, limiting exposure to environments where the virus may persist may help in reducing the incidence of the disease. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to GNP Sir. Give your comments, likes, and share the video.